grabbing a mask when you leave home may now feel like a habit. But our poor brains are still struggling to adapt, because recognizing each other now is not going well.
It's like the biggest experiment in face perception that was ever done. Start memorizing the different faces.
Okay.
For York University cognitive neuroscientist Erez Freud, whose life's work just happens to be studying how we look at and perceive each other, the pandemic has turned the planet into his lab.
We started this investigation to understand how our social interactions, our social abilities are affected by this unprecedented time of the pandemic.
Freud has been watching how we watch others, sampling 500 people at a time around the world every few months, testing their facial recognition. Bottom line, masks reduce our ability to read faces by about 15%.
What makes you think, though, that as time goes on, that we will rewire our brains?
So there are evidence from the face perception literature that shows that our brain can change and adapt and adjust, especially when we are young.
Oh my God, this one is brutal. Dr. Freud, this is impossible.
Wait, this is only the medium.
The test is a version of a famous Cambridge face memory test, which gradually adds more visual noise, changes the angles of faces, making it harder to pick out those you've briefly seen before. The mask complicates it all.
And I feel like I'm not seeing the person, I'm just seeing positioning of eyebrows or something.
Okay, this is a great, I think, description of analytical or local processing.
This is the difference in our brains when we're masked. Unmasked facial recognition happens holistically first. The brain instantly computes the distances between the facial features. The masks make that holistic approach just not possible. So we zero in on features we can see and we perceive them individually. Those, it turns out, who are normally really good at recognizing faces, taking them all in, struggle a lot now.
Face perception is probably the most important visual ability that we have. We use face information not only to identify each other, but also to determine the emotion, gender, even intention.
And so, if we're struggling, then Freud is curious about the consequences. What does this mean, for example, for the development of infants who may only see the whole faces of their immediate family right now? And then there's the elderly. They are already so vulnerable.
Older ages, face perception abilities are impaired to begin with. So I can't imagine how they feel now with the masks on and the isolation. We know for older adults who have difficulties in visual perception suffer or report more on anxiety, social phobia, depression.
So yes, there's anxiety about masks, but also strangely, there's something apparently appealing about them. Researchers in the US asked participants to rate the attractiveness of a cross-section of people with and without masks. They found roughly 70% of reportedly average-looking people were rated as more attractive when wearing a mask.
It impacts the way others see us and how they treat us.
Clinical psychologist David Sarwar has a few theories on that.
What's likely happening is that the mask is camouflaging either prominent features or asymmetrical features of the lower face.
And quite possibly all that conditioning about eyes being the window to the soul has embedded itself.
We're taught when we're talking to somebody to look them right in the eyes. So it's probably part, we're probably seeing part of that socialization effect as well as some ingrained biology that's leading us to be attracted to people's eyes.
There's another theory.
Is it possible to wear a mask seen as a virtuous act? Is it possible that will increase attractiveness?
It's possible. So if someone sees mask as something which is very positive and very important as I do, then I admire and I think highly about people who wear masks. And maybe it affects my perception of those individuals.
So that's the good news, but identifying each other, assessing people's moods from a look, is a real test right now. Speaking of tests.
So a little afraid to ask, how much of a disaster is this?
You can see here your results. attention. So your score for the upright faces was 62, and the average is around 52. So you're doing quite good.
The test, which Freud will keep repeating, is tricky enough, but real life even more so. Because the more impaired we are at really seeing each other, the harder we're going to have to work to really connect.
We need to be more attentive to other people and even take into account the fact that they might not recognize us.
Nearly a year in, the pandemic is asking of us what it did at the beginning. Patience.